I get the latest mega bus you can, or the earliest, it's the cheapest. So it's like, get it for 1:15 in the morning, 1:15 a.m. Get there for like 7:55-ish, to have the full day in London. Then get the last mega bus back, cheapest as well.
Well, the man has cowy face.
I've been here standing for like an hour and a half.
I've always been on time. I've been lucky.
I use the Megabus as like a way to go to London to exhibit. I'm an artist.
Okay.
And, that's what we're doing. We're filming the whole process from 8 to 10.
Brilliant. Got a long way to go then, I think.
Yeah. 6 hours and that.
Brick Lane's where
we're going. Oh, hell, yeah. You sell a curry while you're
down. That's the idea. You've got £5.
You should bring your own drink as well, mate.
Pass that, Luke.
See, the ducks work for MI5, mate.
They do, mate. The ducks, swans. It's one that work for the Queen. I bought one. So, we just got off the mega bus. It's 8:58. And we arrived at, well, I expected it, 7:55. We've got the bus at 1:15. But it's like quite a long journey. But that was the journey that I did every time I was coming to London to exhibit. Cheapest, so I was like, just gotta be a bit of a Spartan, like bear the journey. So I'm used to it now, though, so I'm quite, I don't mind this. I was gonna take everyone through the whole process of how it was for me when I was exhibiting, and I want to show you where I put on my first solo show. I'm gonna go pick a painting from Stolen Space Gallery that I need to come collect. Set the street from Cool Pass London. Shot like Harry Potter, the artist. Like wooden floor. Like get the wooden floor. Got some really nice picnic shots. I got like series 2, like series 1 to 5. And series 5 is next level. Oof. That.
Yeah, I mean, I can imagine.
The dummy tube there. Like series 7. I got the raw pigment of that. Cadmium yellow. That's like my like kind of like my trademark colour. But I got like that one, that one, that one, that one, that one, that one. I got all
Holland.
I've got them as well.
Cadmium. Twice pro Brexit. Try to ban cadmium. When I saw some paintings, I came here. I was just like, I had two bagfuls. Spent about 800 quid. Art materials. I've still got many of them as well. Last long time. I'm heading to the National Gallery. I used to go there a lot. Just watch the little kids sit and draw the paintings. Same thing I did on the tree lines. I've talked about before. But I'm just going to show Jay, E, the majesty of it all. New London though, it's better to walk through the parks than walk next to the roads. Epic, next level pollution in London. Significantly different from somewhere like Ashington. Or Ashington, as people say from there.
What I was saying the other day is like, everybody always says when you say it from Ashington, they're always just like, Ashington. I don't know anybody that says Ashington.
No, only people who aren't from Ashington say like that kind of stuff. Noble 10, you know.
What time is it?
Came last night. In London.
What's all that?
Trafalgar Square. In London, you've got such a bunch of nonsense. I'll Google it one time. Who's he? Who are you? What is that? Looks like you're bringing blood. Hands and legs, my foot.
National Gallery.
That'll be eventually. When you're a British artist, if you're from England or any of the British Isles, the artworks in here, you kind of, your legacy is cemented in history. There's many great artists who aren't in there and who have great legacies anyway, but the ones who are celebrated, you find the work in here.
Aye, aye.
Got the National Gallery. Make cafe there for a little bit. pay about 20 quid for coffee.
Not bad.
Close, you can actually see the brush strokes, the brush marks.
Mm-hmm.
Don't go too far with things as
this.
God, I remember that kingdom. Finished it. Thou art weighed in the balances. Not found one. Those sounds killed the same night. It's a Babylonian king. They often it's funny when you go to like upper class, high class places, like even National Gallery, and like maybe an artist, sometimes get tracked and followed around, made to feel somewhat unwelcome. Bizarre dichotomy of how things are. Favorite artists, Michelangelo, Bruce, the Caravaggio. That's my favorite, because I can relate to him somewhat. My own character. Anyone that knows Caravaggio will understand why. But not with the sword fight anymore. One of the few artists that I can actually relate to when I've learned about artistry.
Peter in court.
Mm. Victor.
Because it wasn't all white, because of where it was located.
Yeah.
I miss what he's making this film. What do you reckon this film? It's the kind of thing that when you're from somewhere like Ashington, like seeing something like this, just the actual architecture of it, it's mind blowing. All this was made by humans. Every single stone was carved by a human, put into place by the mathematical calculation of a human. So to me, this place holds artwork which often makes a lot of fine art pale in comparison. I bow down to the craftsmanship of people that made this kind of stuff that I'll show you soon. Sunk by one of these. Be like a privileged death. Solo show, Asymmetric Yellow. Always by myself, always.
This one, I put a little bag on it so you can carry it.
Yeah,
like,
thank you.
Is that okay?
Yeah, yeah. And I think they might as well, the stretcher bars.
That's the stretcher bars, yeah, we can get them inside.
That's right, thank you.
Is that okay?
Yeah, I carried like 10 times, isn't that? One time. I wish I had two. This, but about, like, not joking, like, probably about 10 paintings in one arm, so I had, like, humongous, pallets of wood, and in this arm I had rolled up paintings, like, linen paintings, wrapped up about 15,000 pounds worth of paintings in my arms, and I was getting rush hour tubes, like, by myself, getting on the megabus. This is how a working class person exists in the fine art world. It's like, from my background, it's what you gotta do. So like Brick Lane, to me, it's been quite a instrumental place in my art career. It's where I put on my first solo show, Asymmetric Yellow, in a gallery I just rented, space I rented. And then eventually I had a solo show in Stone Space Gallery, which is like a big deal, if anyone that knows about art. That's a Crowley House. I used to go there every day, get my dinner. We'll go there later on, get some food. Like £5, used to be £5 for a curry. Drink, rice and chips, right?
I'm really worried about
that's down here, over there, Indian Street. This is where the gallery was. I don't know what's there right now. But I'll show you where it is. Go there and get my drinks, get like morning breakfast, like proper geezer breakfast. That's where it is. So like my first solo show, like one of the biggest issues with that was getting people off the main street and getting footfall to actually come to my show. So I just put posters everywhere, passing all over the street. This is when my very first, this is when my art career started. This is where I sold paintings to Emily Sande. And that black door right there. I don't even know where it is anymore. It's not a gallery for hire anymore. But I think I hired it for, I think it was like about £800 for a week, 7 days hire. This was a gallery. God knows what it is now. Yeah, so my very first solo show, Asymmetric Yellow. Remember it was this area is probably nostalgic, like in a big way. Where it all started.
First update. The northern lines have no service between Kennington and Moorgate is due.
you remember this place, Jamie?
I smashed it. St. James's Street.
Which is where?
A green park. So we had to go the Ritz there.
Past the Ritz.
There. Sorry, mate.
Successful day.
Successful life.
Right now, I'm just sitting waiting to go home. Sitting, just observing what's going on in Trafalgar Square as a demonstration for Ukraine. And a man comes up to us, he asks, "What are you doing? Which way is the train station from here? Which is the tube?" I was like, "Oh, hey, that way or that way. Left or right?" He's like, "Which way is the Northern Line?" I was like, "I'm not sure, mate, I don't know. I'm not like not from here like that." He's like, "So what are you doing right now?" I was like, "Just going home, just like waiting to go home. I'm an artist, picking up paintings." He's like, "Well, do you want to come with me to the train station now? Are you walking the tube?" Like, was that weird or was that weird?
He's smoking the whole time as well. It's so weird.
100% either intelligence agent or undercover police. Like, London's a dark place, man. And like, this is a dodgy town to be in.
Special branch.
right now we're arrived back in Newcastle. It's like 5:05. And this is the Robinson Library. Like, I'm an alumni of Newcastle Uni. So this is my university library. It's open 24 hours a day. And so I'd come here when it was open after lockdown to wait for my first bus home. Like, it's a lifesaver. Which was having that. But yeah, it's like provides somewhere warm to stay until the first bus home. It's also pretty cool. I'd go and check out some books. Something I just wanted to show you, but also like one of the painters that we're looking at in the National Gallery, Velázquez. I was going to say Cain Velázquez. That's an art book.
Mark has a page that's sticking together.
Which was one of the paintings I've actually seen in person. This is what I used to do when I was by myself usually. I'd sit here and just get books. Like at 5 in the morning, 4 in the morning, just read them. Like, mostly look at the paintings really. Look at the pictures. One bit is there.
Put it back together,
all the bits.
Aye. Like a jigsaw.
Took a new part of the library. Wasn't yet. Now I've actually moved. 8 o'clock. Shelf.